Good morning, students. We are studying lesson 2. The name of the lesson is Feelings and Senses. We have read page number 6, 7 and half of the page 8. We have read also. So today we will start with the page 8. Today we will start reading from page 8. The next topic, physically challenged people. We have already done the topic sensing things. So today our new topic is physically challenged people. So children, today we will begin with our page number 8. Our topic for today is physically challenged people. Now underline the word physically and also challenged. Underline the word physically. The spelling is P-H-Y-S-I-C-A-L-L-Y. Physically. Challenged. C-H-A-L-L-E-N-G-E-D. The word is pronounced as challenged. So now children, what does physically challenged mean? Means a physically challenged person is a person whose body does not work properly. Maybe the person is unable to walk, unable to do any of his routine work with the help of his hands, etc. The sense organs of that person may not work properly also. The person may be mentally challenged also. Mentally challenged means the person who is mentally weak, who is weak by his brain, is also known as mentally challenged person. Today we will read this paragraph. First line is, there are many people around us whose sense organs do not function properly. Children, we have studied yesterday what is the meaning of function. Function means purpose. So there are so many people around us whose sense organs do not function properly. Their sense organs do not work. They may be blind, deaf or dumb. Now the children, who is blind? Blind means the person who is unable to see. Now children, who is deaf? The person who is unable to hear is known as deaf. And the third one is dumb, D-U-M-B. The person who is unable to speak is known as dumb. So the blind, deaf or dumb people are known as physically challenged people. Their sense organs are not working properly, so they are physically challenged. Now next line is, some may be mentally challenged or may have some other physical disability. Underline the word mentally challenged. I have told you earlier what is the meaning of mentally challenged. Means who is weak by brain. The person who is weak by brain is known as mentally challenged person. Spelling of mentally is M-E-N-T-A-L-L-Y. Mentally. And the spelling of challenged we have done earlier also. C-H-A-L-L-E-N-G-E-D. Now read on. Or may have some other physical disability. Now underline the word disability. D-I-S-A-B-I-L-I-T-Y. Disability is a term used to denote that if a person is unable to do something, then this is known as physical disability. If a person is unable to do something with the help of his body, then this condition is known as physical disability. Such people are special. Underline the word special. S-P-E-C-I-A-L. Special, you all know, means important. As they need special care and lots of love and attention. So the person who is physically challenged or mentally challenged or having other physical disability must be treated very carefully with most love and attention, because he needs extra attention of people. But reverse is the case. People used to laugh at them. People used to make fun of them. But we should not disrespect such people. We should see them with respect and should take care of them. Now children, there is a blue box given under the paragraph. Now let's see what does this blue box indicates or tell us. The topic of the blue box is Braille. Spelling, underline the word Braille. B-R-A-I-L-E. Braille was a scientist. His full name was Louis Braille. And he has invented Braille script. Now we will read about this Braille. What is Braille script? Saina's neighbor Anil is blind. He cannot see, but he has a very strong sense of touch and smell. Now this is the story of a boy whose name is Anil and who is Saina's neighbor. He is unable to see, but he has a very strong sense of touch and smell. He can touch and smell anything and can tell what that thing is. He can identify, underline the word identify, I-D-E-N-T-I-F-Y. The meaning of the identify is to know something. To know something by just looking or touching or smelling it. He can identify most things by feeling and touching them. If Anil touches something, he can tell what that thing is. So this is a power of touch. Anil cannot read or write like us. Because Anil was blind, so he was not able to read and write like we can do. We all can write and read also, like we are reading just now. But the Anil was not able to read. He uses books written in a special script called Braille script. But the person who is blind can also read and write with the help of a special script known as Braille script. Underline the word script. S-C-R-I-S-C-R-I-P-T. Script. Script means it is a form of writing. Like Roman script is a form of writing of English. Now Anil used to read and write with the help of a special script called as Braille script. It is written on a thick paper. For using Braille script, thick paper must be used. Like we all write on a plain paper, which is very thin. The pages of the copy are very thin also. But in Braille script, thick paper is required. We all need thick paper to read in the Braille script. It is written on a thick paper by marking a row of raised dots with a pointed tool. Now, as we write with the help of pen or pencil, Braille script is written with the help of a pointed tool like a needle or a pen. Such type of thing is used for writing in the Braille script. The book is read by touching the raised dots with the fingers. Now, the dots which are raised over the paper with the help of pen can be read by the person if he touches the dots. A blind person cannot see, but he can use his hands to read the dots which are marked on the thick paper. All the letters of the Braille are made using 1 to 6 dots. How many dots are used in the Braille? There are only 1 to 6 dots which are used in the Braille, not more than that. We only used 1 to 6 dots to read or write in the Braille script. This script was invented by Louis Braille. Louis Braille is the name of the person who himself was blind. Louis Braille was a blind person. So he had invented the Braille script for reading and writing for himself. Braille can now be written using a computer. Now, children, you all know that technology has advanced a lot. Now, children, we all know that there is so much advancement in the field of science and technology these days. So, nowadays also Braille script can also be written using a computer. As we can type and write on a computer screen, likewise Braille can also be written using a computer. So, it is a very big advancement right now that Braille can also be written using a computer. Now, coming to the next part of the page 8, it is our responsibility to help the physically challenged people in whatever way we can. Children, we always keep in mind that we should do our bit to help the physically challenged people. Whatever we can do for them, we should do it. We should not wait for others to do it. We should not see others if they are doing or not. We should do our bit, whatever we can, to help the physically challenged people. And it's also our responsibility also. We can be their friends. We should also make them our friends also, and we should also share our time and things with them, like we do with our normal friends. So we also can make them friends and share our time and things with them. So we can be their friends and share our time and things with them. We should always encourage them to excel in life. Underline the word excel. E-X-C-E-L. Excel means to rise in life. Now, children, your assignment for today is write all the hard words in your notebook which are given in this video. Number second, learn spellings and meanings of all the hard words. Number third, write briefly about Louis Braille and Braille script. Whatever you have read in the chapter, try to write it in your notebook. I hope you must have understood the topic. Okay, thank you, children.